Today I'm going to show you how to make super fused objects inside of Blender. Whenever I post these designs on my Instagram, I get a lot of likes, and with those likes comes a lot of questions as well. So let's see how it's done. Right now you can see these are the shapes that we are going to fuse together. Right now they are all separate. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of them, Ctrl Shift Plus. They all become a single object. That is what we want. But right now they are not merged together. What happens if I'm going to add a bevel to this? If I add a bevel to it, you can see that nothing changed much. The reason why that is happening is because if you go in here, you can see the topology is a mess. So there are basically two ways to fix the topology of the object we have right now. The first one would be to manually go in and fix everything, which is not a great way to do it because it takes a lot of time and you would need to have a very good understanding of how topology works. And the second method would be to converting our mesh into volume and volume back into mesh and remeshing it. I'm going to show you how that works because that is a much more easier way to do things. So I'm going to delete the bevel, add a volume empty, and go to the add modifier, and here you can see we have a mesh to volume in here. And if I select our object in here, it's turning our mesh into volume. But right now it is a bit less visible, right? I'm going to crank the density to 10 so that the volume becomes more visible. I want the volume to be much more sharp. Right now you can see it's very cloudy, right? I'm going to hit 128 in our voxel amount. Maybe I'll go to 1024. And the higher you crank up the voxel amount, the more processing time it takes. So do keep that in mind. Okay, that looks good. And right now you can see the mesh is over here, but the volume is expanding from that mesh. So how can we fix that? That is because of this exterior bandwidth. I can just decrease that to 0.01. And yeah, that fixes that. I'm going to hide my mesh for now. And we have this volume. Okay, that looks good. But we don't want the volume, right? We need the volume to be a mesh. For that, I'm going to add a mesh cube. With the cube selected, I can go and add a volume to mesh modifier. And the volume to mesh modifier asks for an object. So I'm going to click the eyedropper, select our volume. Okay, right now we have got the mesh. Yeah, I'm going to hide the volume of it as well. This is the mesh we have right now. I'm going to apply the modifier for this one. And if I hit tab and go into our edit mode, you can see it has a lot more detail in it. A lot more points and vertices. So now our goal should be to decrease the number of vertices and make this super smooth. So there are basically two methods to do that. The first one would be to use the inbuilt feature in Blender, which is free, and the second one would be to use a paid add-on. So let me show you the free method first. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select this, go to remesh voxel mode, set the voxel size to 0.05 and voxel remesh it. Okay, it made the geometry much more smoother. Now I'm going to go to quad remesher and let's try 3500 faces. Okay, that is how it looks. I'm going to add a shade smooth and an auto smooth to it. Now, right now you can see the edges are super jagged and that is the trade-off of using the free method. But we can easily fix that using Control 2, which adds two levels of subdivision and well, it becomes less obvious. Now let me show you how to use a paid add-on called Quad Remesher to get much better results. Once you have installed the add-on inside of Blender, you can find that over here. And like you can specify how much faces you want and you can hit remesh and it remeshes it. And that looks pretty good. And if I hit tab to go into the edit mode, you can see the topology is amazing in here. Like the edges and everything is super smooth. And that is how you can make super fused objects inside of Blender.